Inside sales has become more and more popular, especially with everything going on in the world. Now, people are finally discovering that actually you don't have to meet someone in person. You can actually do everything online, remotely, and even from the comfort of your own home, as long as you got a computer and a phone. So in this video, I'm gonna show you exactly what inside sales is, how it works, the different mechanics of it, and what the difference is between, you know, working inside sales and going to an office versus inside sales working from home. What's going on, everybody? It's Patrick Dan here. Before we go ahead and get started, make sure to give this video a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications if you wanna see more sales videos like this. Now, the first thing we gotta do is we wanna first define what inside sales is. So the definition we are gonna use is inside sales is a B2B sales role where a person is selling a product or service remotely through the phone, email, and other online channels, you know, pretty much anything using the internet. Now, when I first started my career at Oracle, technically I started out as an inside sales rep. Now, important distinction to understand is that you can be an inside sales rep working at a company, going into the office every day, and that would be considered inside sales. And the reason is because you are actually selling mostly remotely, but you are required to go to an office. So most of the time when I was at Oracle, I would be on my computer in the office every single day on the phone or, you know, writing emails and trying to sell my products and services. And if, you know, if it was an important client where we really wanted to meet them in person, occasionally we would fly out to the, you know, company we want to work at and maybe pitch our product and service in a formal, you know, demo and presentation. But, you know, for the most part, most of the selling happened remotely. Now, the other end of the spectrum where instead of, you know, going to the office every day and selling remotely, some companies may allow you to sell from the comfort of your own home if they feel that you don't need the in-person training with everybody in the office and, you know, that culture that comes with that. If you know what you're doing and you want to work from home, there are also roles where you're an inside salesperson, but you take all your calls and do all your meetings from anywhere you want as long as you have internet. So now that we understand, you know, exactly what inside sales is and the two different ways it can work, and let's go ahead and put that side by side with outside sales, or also known as field sales. So for an outside sales job, that's primarily a sales job where you're constantly on the road or you're constantly outside, you know, prospecting, looking for customers and, you know, closing deals. So an example would be, let's say if you are in a real estate agent and how you get your customers is you go door to door, knocking on everyone's door, asking if they want to sell their home or if they want to buy a home. And, you know, you knock on 100 doors, maybe one person says they actually are looking to sell their home, then you got a prospect right there. So in that situation, a lot of it is outside. You're literally outside of an office going to your customer, meeting face to face. This could also be true for any type of where you're going door to door selling, let's say a vacuum or car detailing or pretty much anything that you can, you know, sell door to door. That would be outside sales. Or if you're going company to company and maybe you're bringing along, you know, product samples and things like that, and you're showing the person exactly what you got and you want to see whether or not they want to buy, that would also be field sales as well. Now, when it comes to payment, both outside sales and inside sales can pay well if you do well in either jobs, right? Because for sales, the more you sell, the more money that you actually make. But obviously, when it comes to which one is easier in terms of, you know, physical endurance, obviously inside sales is a lot easier because you're inside an air conditioned room for the most part and you're sending emails and you're on the phone and you don't have to physically do labor. It's more about, you know, how mentally strong you are and how good you are at selling. But for outside sales, you have to be very good at selling, obviously, and you have to have the physical endurance to go door to door, company to company, and actually try to pitch your product or service. So, you know, which one should you actually do? Really just depends on which one is more your style and which one you wanna do. Do you wanna be out in the field talking to customers in person and going door to door, or do you wanna be inside sending cold emails and taking meetings over the phone? Now, next, when it comes to inside sales, we're gonna be talking about the different type of sales roles within inside sales. So sales is constantly evolving and, you know, there are different roles popping up and it's becoming more and more specialized, right? So the main ones that you have to know is basically sales development reps, also known as business development reps, and account executives and account managers. These are gonna be the three that typically, you know, you're gonna get the most exposure to as a beginner salesperson. Now, for a sales development rep and business development rep, you are inside, let's say inside an office or you're working from home, and all your job is to find people that your company may wanna work with, and you do outbound prospecting, meaning you send these people a cold email, LinkedIn message, or you are cold calling, right? And so that's gonna be the sales development side where you're just generating meetings. Once you generate the meetings, account executives are the people that actually get on the meeting and close the deal. So these two specialized sales roles are very different, right? One is more research-based and just kinda, you know, you actually don't even have to be on the phone if you're not cold calling, you're just sending messages to get someone to agree to a meeting. An account executive is a whole different skill set where you're on the phone, you're listening to the person's problem, and you are selling and pitching your product or service. An account manager, just to give you a quick summary, is a person who handles the customer after the deal is closed. They renew the customer and get that customer to spend more money. All these roles, incredibly important for sure, but you know, the main thing I want to let you guys know is that all these roles can also be done inside. And a lot of companies, like let's say Oracle, which I used to work at, or startups, Microsoft, Salesforce, you know, they all have inside sales teams and specialized roles for each of these categories. And one of the big benefits to actually learning these sales roles or getting experience in them is that because, you know, once you get the hang of things and you know how to deal with customers, and pretty much everything is already done remotely anyways, it's just that you're going into the office every day, you know, with what's going on, a lot of sales teams are actually moving remote, where people are doing the exact same job they were doing in the office, except now they're doing it from home because they realize that if you already know these skills and it's more of a routine that you consistently improve, you don't need to technically go into the office. And that's kind of where the future is at. Once you learn the skills and you understand the company culture, you don't need to go to the office as long as you're doing a good job. So my prediction moving forward in the future, let's say like 2025 or 2030, I personally think that a lot of sales jobs that are traditionally inside sales where you go into the office every day, it's gonna change. And it's gonna be like, you know, there are certain people that go into the office every day and that's gonna be that, but there are gonna be a lot more people who, you know, learn from the office, get the culture, and then they're just gonna work from home. And as long as they're happy, they're doing good work, and they're doing just as good work or if not better than they would if they went to the office, there's really no need for an office. And that actually helps a company a lot more because it lowers their overhead. They don't have to rent such a big office space if they know that people are willing to work from the comfort of their own homes. And obviously for you, if you are, you know, a salesperson, you're probably thinking like, yeah, that actually would be nice if you can just work from home because you can just be comfortable and work on your own time. And as long as you get the work done, it doesn't actually matter. So that is everything we have to cover when it comes to inside sales. Let me know in the comments if you also feel like in the future, a lot of these jobs where you have to traditionally go into the office are just gonna be completely remote and everyone's gonna work from home. Let me know if you have that prediction as well. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications because I'm gonna be dropping new videos every single week. And if you wanna learn more about sales and high ticket closing or even remote sales, make sure you check out my other videos. So with that said, my name is Patrick Dang. Hope you guys crush it in your sales career, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next one.